Hello students, today we are going to see the reduced syllabus of subject economy for 12 commerce, and the board is in Gujarat State Education Board. So let's see the reduced syllabus for March 2021. Because of this pandemic, the board has reduced the syllabus, and that syllabus supposed to be keep in mind for the students who are going to appear for the exam of March 2021. So let's see that. Okay, let's see the reduced syllabus for 2021, and the subject is account for the Gujarat State Education Board. So this is for the GSEB. So here we can see that in the economics, the chapter 1, in the chapter 1, the name of the chapter is a graph in economics. In that, introduction is included. So here what I have written is included. That is in the syllabus, and here it is deducted. That means it is excluded from the syllabus. So here we can see that in chapter number 1, introduction is there, meaning of diagram and graph is there. Type of diagram in there, only two type of diagram is included. That is lattice diagram and the other one is a bar diagram. The third one, pie diagram, is excluded. So no graph will be asked for the pie diagram. There will be no other thing for the pie diagram will be there. So that is excluded. And here aspect to be considered while drawing pie diagram, that is also excluded. So two types of diagram is included here. Then the types of graph, all types of graph is included. And use of technology in the study of economics, that is also included in the syllabus. Now let's see the chapter number 2. Chapter number 2 is an indicator of growth and development. In that, introduction is included, meaning of economic growth, meaning of economic development, that is also included. Difference between growth and development, that is also in the syllabus. Indicator of development, that is also included. See here, indicator of development, in that we can see that national income is there, and per capita income is also an indicator of development. So that is included. Only limitation is excluded. So the limitation of national income is excluded, as well as limitation of per capita income is also excluded. So other point related to national income and per capita income, that we have to study for the board exam. So that two points are only excluded from this chapter number 2. Now let's talk about the chapter number 3. So in that, that is money and inflation. That is very important chapter for the economics, and that nothing is excluded. That means whole chapter is there in the syllabus. So we have to see whole chapter for the board exam. Chapter number 4, that is banking and monetary policy. In that we can see that the introduction is included. Evolution and meaning of the banks is also included. Next is the classification of banks, that is also included. Commercial banks and function of commercial bank. In that, in a primary function, function number 1, 2, 3 and 5 is included. Only function of commercial bank. In that point number 4, that is credit creation. Only that point is excluded. In that, student, make it note nicely that in a primary function, all the other 4 functions, that is included. Only one function is excluded, that is credit creation. So we have to see primary function as well as secondary function. But in a primary function, only one function we have to exclude, that is credit creation. So function of commercial bank, that is primary and secondary, that we have to see. Then there is a central bank, that also we have to see. And monetary policy, that is also we have to see. Here only present of commercial bank in India. So 2 points is excluded from the chapter number 4, that is banking and monetary policy. That is the function of commercial bank, in that only one function, that is credit creation, that is excluded. And presence of commercial bank in India, that is also excluded. So 2 points from the chapter number 4. Student, you may make the screenshot of this, then we'll see next chapter. Chapter number 5, that is coding. In coding, you can see that banking is deducted from the syllabus. So here, the syllabus that is included housing scheme is excluded. Social security scheme is also excluded. And then that is Jandhan Yojana. So all the things that is very hard for student to remember, that is excluded from the syllabus in the chapter poverty. Next chapter is unemployment. In unemployment, what is in the syllabus is the introduction, then meaning of unemployment, then type of unemployment. In that 3, 4, 5, that type of unemployment is included. But very first two unemployment, that is open unemployment and underemployment, that is excluded from the syllabus. So here only 2 points are excluded. The whole chapter is there. So type of unemployment in that 6.2.3 is there, 6.2.4 and 6.2.5. That is types of unemployment is in the syllabus. Then the causes of unemployment is also in the syllabus. Measures to reduce unemployment, that is also there. And state program to solve the unemployment program, that is also included. So in this chapter only 2 points are excluded from the syllabus for the board March 2021 exam. Okay. Next is a chapter number 7, that is population. In the population we can see that introduction is there, meaning of population explosion is there. Then 7.2, that is population trend in India. In that 7.2.1 is there, but 7.2.2, that is the male and female population in India, that is also for gender distribution of population in India, that is excluded. Then 7.2.3 is included, and 7.2.4, that is age wise population in India, that is excluded. And then 7.2.5 is included. So here only 2 points is excluded, that is male female population in India and age wise population in India, that is excluded. Other point of population trend in India is included in the syllabus. Okay, causes of rapid increase in population growth, that is also there, and measures to control population, that is also included in the syllabus. So that is for chapter number 7, that is population. Now let's see, next chapter is 8 number, and that is agriculture sector. So here in agriculture sector, you can see that the introduction is there, importance of agriculture sector, that is very important, that is also included in the syllabus. Next is a present situation of agriculture sector in India. So how is the agriculture sector in India nowadays, that is also included here. Next is a causes of low productivity of agriculture in India, that is also included. Next is a measures to increase the agriculture productivity, that is also included. And next is a 8.5 is a modern agriculture. In that only 1 point is included, that is green revolution. The other points, that is 8.5.2, 8.5.3 and 8.5.4, that are excluded. Where we can see that 8.5.1 is a green revolution, 8.5.2 is a multiple cropping, that is excluded from the syllabus. Next is 8.5.3 is a crop production, that is also excluded from the syllabus. And 8.5.4, that is agriculture research, that is also excluded from the syllabus. So student, you may make the screenshot of this, then we will see the next remaining 3 chapters, that is 9, 10 and 11. Okay, let's see the next chapter, that is chapter number 9, foreign trade. In the foreign trade, where first point is the introduction, that is included. Then the meaning of domestic and international trade, that is also included in the syllabus. Then 9.2 is the reason for international trade. Why there is a need of international trade, that is also included. Then 9.3, that is factor affecting the nature of international trade, that is excluded from the syllabus. Then 9.4, that is a difference between domestic and international trade, that is included in the syllabus. Then 9.5, that is the magnitude of world trade in present time. Then 9.6 is India's share in global trade. Then 9.7 is a size, composition and direction of India's foreign trade. Then 3 points, that is very major point of foreign trade, that is excluded from the syllabus. Then 9.8, that is the concept of balance payment, that is important and that is included in the syllabus, and the concept of exchange rate. these two points are very important, and that is included. And the other three points that is excluded from the syllabus. So here also this chapter is very important for the board exam for that. Next is chapter number 10, that is an industrial sector. In that, introduction is included. Then 10.1, that is the importance of industrial sector, that is important. 10.2, industrial structure, that is also included. Then 10.3, that is measure taken by government for industrial development, that is excluded from the syllabus. So you don't have to see this point. Then 10.4, that is special economic zones, that is included. And 10.5, that is importance of small scale industry, that is included. So here in this chapter only one point is excluded, that is measure taken by government for industrial development. That is chapter number 10. And this is our last chapter, that is emerging issue in Indian economy. In that, this chapter is also very small, and from that also two major point is reduced. So only very small part of this chapter is in your syllabus. So that is introduction and migration. And the next is 11.2, that is urbanization. In that, only two point is included, that is 11.2.1 and 11.1.2.2. The third one, that is measures to reduce the problem of urbanization, that is excluded from your syllabus, and infrastructure service, that is also excluded. So student, this